Hello learners, I am Manish Sharma, Assistant Professor, MIT University. Today we will learn about the problems of unemployment, poverty and inequality. You will be able to learn about the causes of unemployment, know the government policies and programs implemented to alleviate poverty and generate employment, and evaluate the extent and causes of regional disparity in our country. Causes of unemployment: slow economic growth, increase in labor force, rural-urban migration are few reasons why we have unemployment in our country. Adding to those, inappropriate technology, defective educational system, lack of employability and lack of infrastructure development are the few major reasons why we have unemployment in our country. Now, let us discuss these issues one by one. The first important reason why we have unemployment in our country is slow economic growth. During the planning period, the trend rate of growth was considered lower than the targeted rate. That means, whatever we were targeting, the actual growth rate is less than that which was targeted. Therefore, jobs in adequate number were not created. Further, economic growth by itself does not solve the problem of unemployment. In the recent past, there is a decrease in the growth of employment in spite of the accelerated economic growth. This can be explained in terms of steady decline in the degree of response of employment to change in output in all the major sectors of economic activity except in construction. If you see, the economy is growing, the GDP is increasing, but still we have a problem of unemployment. According to T.S. Popola, over a period of time, the output growth in agriculture and manufacturing sector has become more input and technology intensive and less labor intensive. That means, in agriculture and manufacturing sector, we can produce or we can have the production activity by using both the labor intensive and technology intensive techniques. So besides the sectoral composition of growth is also an important determinant of unemployment. Excessive dependence on agriculture and slow growth of non-farm activities limit employment generation in our economy. Increase in labor force because of rapid population growth and because of social factors are adding to the problems of unemployment. Coming to the first part, rapid population growth. Population is rising in our country, the labor supply is rising in our country, but that much opportunities, employment opportunities are not available. That is the reason it is adding to the problem of unemployment. Social factors. Since independence, education among women has changed their attitude toward employment. Many of them now compete with men for job in the labor market, which was earlier not there in the economy. With the men, now the woman is also available for employment. So the economy has, however, failed to respond to these challenges, and the net result is a continuous increase in unemployment backlogs, which is there in the economy. Another reason is rural-urban migration. People from the rural area are migrating to the urban areas. They are coming to the urban areas for seeking employment. Rural areas have failed to provide subsistence living in agriculture. That is the reason they are trying to move to the urban areas for their employment opportunities. That will result in the unemployment in the urban areas. However, economic development in cities has failed to create enough additional jobs for the new urban entrants to the labor market, those who are coming from the rural areas. Thus, only some of the migrants are absorbed in the production activities and rest of the people will join the existing army of unemployed people, which will increase the unemployment in the urban areas. Another reason for unemployment is inappropriate technology. In India, capital is a scarce resource which is available for the production, but labor is available in abundance. Yet, producers and manufacturers are increasing the use of capital for labor. They are not preferring the labor but capital for their production. This policy results in larger unemployment. Despite the abundance of labor, capital-intensive technology is adopted in India, mainly because of rigid labor laws. That is the reason most of the organizations are using more capital as compared to the labors. Right sizing of manpower is difficult for the enterprises. Further, the factors like labor unrest and lack of work culture leads to the increased inefficiency of labor and thus provide incentives to the organizations to follow labor-saving technology in their production setup. Let us talk about another reason of unemployment in our country, which is defective educational system. The present educational system has theoretical bias and has limited utility for productive purposes. The practical orientation is missing. It lacks the emphasis on the development of aptitude and technical qualifications required for various types of work among the job seekers. That is the reason we have a gap in industry and academia, and that is the reason we are not having the required skill set which are required in the industry, and the people are unemployed. This has created a mismatch between the need and availability of relevant skills and training, which results in unemployment. The another reason for unemployment is lack of infrastructure development. Lack of investment and infrastructure development limits the growth and productive capacity of different sectors, which leads to inadequate generation of employment opportunities in the economy. If less investment is there in the infrastructure, less opportunity will be there for the employment. Another reason is lack of employability. India faces poor health and nutrition situation among masses, which reduces the capacity of a person to be employable and is a result of unemployment. If a person is not healthy, in that case, he will leave the job because of health conditions and will be unemployed. Next topic is poverty, the another problem for an economy. Poverty can be defined as a situation when people are unable to satisfy the basic needs of life. The definition and the methods for measuring poverty differs from country to country. The extent of poverty in India is measured by the number of people living below the poverty line. So, in India, poverty line is the major concept that we will use for defining the poverty. Poverty line defines a threshold income. Households earning below this threshold are considered poor. Different countries have different methods of defining the threshold income depending on local socio-economic needs of that particular country. In India, the Planning Commission releases the poverty estimates. Poverty is measured based on consumer expenditure surveys of the NSSO, which is National Sample Survey Organization. A poor household is defined as the one with an expenditure level below a specific poverty line. A person who is not able to earn that much, which is being defined in poverty line, will be called a poor person or a person living below the poverty line. Now, what is that poverty line? Earlier, India used to define the poverty line based on a method defined by a task force in 1979. It was based on expenditure for buying food worth 2400 calories in rural areas and 2100 calories in urban areas. So whatever expenditure we will make in buying the food, which is less than 2400 calories and 2100 calories in urban areas, was defined as the poverty line. But in 2009, the Suresh Tendulkar committee defined the poverty line on the basis of monthly spending on food, education, health, electricity and transport. So earlier we were only considering food, but now education, health, electricity and transport are also included when we define the poverty line. The Planning Commission has updated the poverty line and poverty ratios for the year 2009 and 2010 as per the recommendation of the Tendulkar committee. It has estimated the poverty lines at all India level as monthly per capita consumption expenditure, we call it MPCE, monthly per capita consumption expenditure of rupees 673 for rural areas and rupees 860 for urban areas. That means a person who spent less than rupees 673 in rural areas and less than 860 in urban areas per month is defined to be a person below the poverty line. Based on these cutoffs, the percentage of people living below the poverty line in the country has declined from 37.2% in 2004-05 to 29.8% in 2009-10. Even in absolute terms, the number of poor people has fallen by 52.4 million during the period. That means 48.1 million in rural poor and 4.3 million in urban poor. Thus, poverty has declined on an average by 1.5 percentage points per year between 2004-05 and 2009-10. Now, we have one table which explains the poverty ratio in different years. If you see, in 1993-94, 50% people in the rural areas were poor, in the urban it was 31%, and the combined average of the country, including both rural and urban, was 45%. In 2004-05, if you see the figure, the rural, now it is only 41%, and in 2009-10, 33% people of the population in the rural area are poor, in urban 20%, and in both 29% people are poor as per the new estimates or as per the suggestions of the new poverty line estimates by Tendulkar committee. Now let us try to understand the causes of poverty in India. Vicious circle of poverty, low resource endowment, inequality in the distribution of income and asset. These are the major reasons why we have poverty in our country. Adding to these, lack of access to social services, lack of access to institutional credit, price rise in the economy, and lack of productive employment are the another reasons which causes poverty in our country. The first major reason is vicious circle of poverty. It is said that a country is poor because it is poor. The idea has come down from Ragnar Nergse, who pinpointed the problem of the vicious circle of poverty in a country. Low level of saving reduces the scope for investment, and which in turn will result to lesser income for that person, and thus the circle of poverty goes on indefinitely. What do we mean by that? It says, if you are saving low, you will be able to invest low, or your investment will be low. If your income is low, in that case, you will be further able to save low, and there will be a vicious circle of poverty, and you will not be able to generate much money for yourself. Another problem is low resources endowment. A household is poor if the sum total of income earning assets, which it commands, include land, capital, and labor of various levels of skills, cannot provide an income above the poverty line. The poor mainly consist of unskilled labor, which typically does not command a high enough level of wage income. So, he will remain poor. Another reason of poverty in our country is inequality in the distribution of income and assets. The distribution of income and assets also determine the level of income for a person. The economic inequality are the major causes of poverty in India. It means the benefit of the growth have been concentrated and have not trickled down sufficiently to ensure improved consumption among the lower income group. Rather, the income is being distributed, or richers are getting more richer and poor is becoming more poor. Another reason for poverty is lack of access to social services, services which are available in the society. The lack of access to social services such as health and education compound the problems of inequality. That means when you are not educated, you will not be getting much income because you are not employed, and that will result in the unemployment and will further result in the poverty. The poor typically get much lesser than a fair share of services which are intended for the poor people, maybe because of lack of awareness, lack of information about the existence of those services, or lack of knowledge and corruption in our economy. Another reason for poverty is lack of access to institutional credit. The banks and other financial institutions are biased in providing the loans to the poor people because they have a fear of having a default of repayment. So that is the reason they may not give the loans to the poor people, those who actually require, and which will further result in the poverty or reduced income for those people. The inaccessibility to institutional credit may force poor to take credit from the landlord or other informal sources at a very high interest rate, and which in turn may weaken their position in other areas. For example, to the payment of abnormally high rental shares for land, or acceptance of abnormally low wages in various types of bonded labor arrangements, or selling their crop at a very low rate will result in further poverty for these people, those who are engaged in the production of different crops. Another reason for poverty is price rise. As we know, there is an inflation in the economy, the prices of general level of goods and services are increasing, which will result in the decrease in the purchasing power of money, and now a poor person has to buy goods which are very expensive in the economy or which are beyond the capacity of that person, and which will result and add to the poverty for that person. Lack of productive employment is another reason, because if employment opportunities are not available in an economy because of the problem of infrastructure, inputs, credit, technology, or the marketing support, again, a person will not be employed, and if a person or poor person is not employed, will not get the employment opportunity, that will add to the poverty for that person. Now, we have some social causes also which are adding to the poverty in a particular economy. Education, caste system, and social customs are the issues which we have to deal with. The first point is education. If a person is not educated, if he is not having the skill sets, if he is not having the qualification to a job which will give him a good income, so he will do a job where the exploitation is there by the manufacturers or by the producers, and as a result, low income a person will get, and which will add to the poverty of that person. Caste system. Caste system in India has always been responsible for rural poverty. In rural areas, the subordination of the low caste people by the high caste people caused the poverty of the former. Due to rigid caste system, the low caste people could not participate in various economic activities, and as a result, they remained poor. The another reason for the poverty is social customs, especially in the rural areas. The rural people generally spend a large percentage of annual earnings on social ceremonies like marriages, death, and borrow largely to meet these requirements. As a result, they are not able to pay back to those from where they have taken the credit, and as a result, they become poor, and which will further result in the suicides in our country. So, dear listeners, today we have understood what do we mean by unemployment, what are the causes of unemployment in our country, what do we mean by poverty line, what were the suggestions of Tendulkar committee, and what are the reasons of poverty in our economy. Thank you so much.